Welcome everyone to another Malware Geek review. Today we're going to be taking a look at Malware Buster. This has been a highly requested item for a while, and I was actually contacted on Facebook by one of the representatives from the company that makes this product. They gave me a 14-day trial and asked me to review the product, so I figured today was a good day to do so. There are a couple of things that I want to get out of the way right off the bat with this product. The first being that their trial system, in my opinion, is a little annoying and kind of weird. When you go to their website, they offer you a free scan, as they call it. What it actually does is download the free version of this particular product, and then they offer you to buy it now. I started tinkering around with the free version, which has real-time protection active, but when you actually go to remove the malware, it asks you to pay. Now, I don't necessarily have a problem with that system because Hitman Pro implements a similar system where, you know, they ask you to pay to remove the malware, but there's a difference between this product and Hitman Pro. The first difference being that Hitman Pro does not offer real-time scanning. It's just malware removal and that's it. Also, Hitman Pro does offer you a trial version where you can actually remove the malware, try the full product, and then you have to pay after, I think it's 30 days or something like that. This product has no such trial. You actually have to request the trial. So if you're going to, you know, provide an anti-malware product to someone that you want them to pay for, I think it's a good idea to offer them a trial that actually functions fully. So that's my first complaint. My second thing about this product is that when it installs, it automatically starts a system scan. Now, that's not necessarily a bad thing. I know a lot of products do that. F-Secure wanted me to do that on the other review. Komodo wants you to do that, and that's fine, but it doesn't really give the user the option to do so. It just starts it automatically. And being that this is a clean system, I really feel that, you know, you should give the user that option. Give them the option to say yes or no or whatever. Now, of course, Komodo will annoy you if you don't scan the computer, but, you know, it doesn't just automatically start. It allows you to take the time whenever you have the time to do so and start the scan. So I think that option should be fixed. So that's just one thing that I find just a little bit annoying. So enough with my ramblings. If we dive into the product and we take a look at its user interface, it's a fairly clean user interface. You have a scan button here on the main user interface. You can switch between quick, full, and custom. Tells you how many whether you had a scan that was run, how many malicious files were blocked, and how many malicious files were removed. Tells you that the malware protection, ransomware protection, and adware protection are on. I believe this disappears after you run a scan. I actually stopped the scan in the middle of it because it just automatically started doing it when I installed the product. So over here you have your history. Tells you about the scans and, you know, malware being blocked and removed, kind of like the main page does. And then over here under your settings, you have your general settings. There's not a lot of advanced settings with this product. I did talk to the company. They say that this is a cloud-based anti-malware solution. So this seems more like a second opinion scanner, so it would complement your antivirus, but I would still expect this product to perform, you know, fairly well for a second opinion scanner, much like Zamana. Zamana is a second opinion scanner, but it performs fairly well. So you have your context menu scanning options, gamer mode, updates, under protection, auto run if it launches with Windows, and real-time protection. Your scheduled scans here, your whitelist, which it will not scan. Quarantine is obviously where the malware is going to be quarantined after it's removed. Proxy settings, and of course your license, which I'm not going to go to. So the last thing I really want to say about this particular product, oops, I didn't want to do that, is that this box right up here where it says talk to their techs, I kind of think this is a waste of space. You could have this in an about menu or maybe over here somewhere or something like that. I just think that this is a big waste of space. I understand that you're maybe trying to, you know, sell some, you know, technical support or something like that, but does it really have to take up this much space on the user interface? I know, like I've said, other products do this. Komodo is one that comes to mind, but you can dismiss the alert. So I just think that they should just put this somewhere else, you know, or whatever. So that's that. It is up to date. It's a cloud-based anti-malware solution. There is actually no update button whatsoever on this product at all. Not here in the menu, not in the settings menu, except down, where is it? Yeah, right here. So it does it automatically. So there's really no way to force an update. So maybe that's something they want to think about, but, you know, whatever. So we have our malware links here. These are fairly fresh. So we're going to test Malware Buster and see how well it does against some malicious links. So here's our first link. Before we do that, let me check the memory usage. I always forget to do that. It's not the lightest product for a second opinion scanner, but it's definitely not extremely heavy either. So, you know, it's not too bad. I haven't really noticed a system slowdown, so I really can't complain about that. So anyways, here's our first file. YouTube by click setup.exe. Possibly adware. Not really sure. It looks like it's successfully executed, though. The real-time protection is active. Yeah, this looks like some sort of adware or something. They do have adware protection, so they'll show you real-time protection is active. It might be some kind of a bundled software thing, too. I don't really know. Looks like it's downloading stuff, so possibly bundled software. But anyways, we will move on. That could be legitimate, too. It didn't look legitimate when I looked at the virus total stuff, but that doesn't mean anything. This is actually a phishing website. So we will move on from that. I don't think it drops any kind of malware on the system. So I'll have to grab another link. Here's our next link. This, I believe, was some sort of an infected page, but it may not be infected any longer. So we'll move right along. Here's our next file. Okay, that one, what did that one do? Anything? Some sort of weird, I'll just click some buttons. Like any, this looks like some more adware. So, a lot of adware links today. Here's our next link. This is probably some sort of a script. Let's see if it loads anything weird into memory. It doesn't appear to be doing anything, so we will move right along. Okay, we will save this one as a EXE on the desktop. That one seems to be running in the background. Yep, right there. So that's definitely not a legitimate file. Just by the file name, I can tell that it's malicious. 5.exe. Your legitimate files are not going to be named 5.exe. Here's our next file, smt.exe. That one has also made it into memory. So far, it has not caught anything. So that's kind of concerning. And we have a lot of weird things in memory. So far, it has not blocked a single file. And it is active on the system. So not quite understanding why that is, but okay. Here's our next file. That one gets through as well, right there. Application requires a .NET framework. So I'm not sure if that's some kind of .NET framework ransomware or something like that. Possibly could be. Here's our next executable file, money.exe. Guarantee you it will not be providing you with any kind of money. It will probably be stealing your money. But it didn't look like it was doing anything malicious. So I'll grab another link. I have to grab about three more or something like that. Chrome.exe. It doesn't appear to have caught that one. Nope. And it's gone out of memory. So, yeah. Okay. Well, let me grab about three more links and then I'll be back in just a minute. Okay, so as I was grabbing some links, you can clearly see we have some ransomware on here. It appears to be Locky ransomware. It's taken over the desktop, which is kind of sad because, it looks like it killed Malwarebuster too. Because Malwarebuster was running and then it closed. So it appears that it says it's blocked some malware, but if we look at our pictures here, they're probably going to be encrypted. Yep. So, and it says it has ransomware protection. Well, didn't stop this ransomware. And it appears it was killed by a malware process. So that's not good. That's not good at all. So, I don't know even know if my links are even there anymore. Nope. I don't think they are. Well, actually they are. Wow, that's amazing. So, that's disappointing. It didn't do anything to stop the ransomware, and it says it has ransomware protection. So, I don't know about that. Looks like it caught some kind of malware DLL file. Yeah, a couple DLL files, but it didn't stop the encryption process at all. So anyways, okay, so now it's detecting stuff. That's really weird. It's taking that took forever. It's allowing the malware to execute and then it's detecting it. That just seems kind of a weird way to do things, but okay. Well, what I'm going to do is I'm going to grab another link and then we'll continue. Okay, so we will punch these last three links in and then we'll finish up this part of the test. Here's the first file. It doesn't look like it caught that one. Nope. Rave Project is the name on it. Description, yeah, well, whatever that is. Definitely not legitimate. Okay, let's try the next one. This one is a script, I think. Okay, it caught that one. Threat.spoofed. Suspicious is what it says, so we will apply the actions to remove the malware. So it does function, it just doesn't seem to have a very high detection ratio. So let's try this next executable file. Okay, so it removed the malware. It wants me to run a quick scan, but I'm not going to run a quick scan. If it got rid of the malware, that's all I care about. I don't think it caught that one either. I don't see it. It's somewhere running around. Yeah, I don't see it. It's in there somewhere. There's a command prompt running, though. That's definitely not legitimate. Okay, so that's enough. So obviously it's pretty obvious we have some ransomware on here. So it says it's blocking malware files, but I'm not really sure about that. Yeah, it looks like it was that script it blocked. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to do a scan with Hitman Pro and Zamana. and then I'll be back with the results. Okay, so another thing I wanted to point out to everyone, when I open up the web browser, we get redirected to, this was not the default homepage, obviously, we get redirected to this random Chinese website. So we definitely have some adware on here as well. So that's messing with our browser. So I'm going to go ahead and see what we got going on here, and I'll be back with the results. Okay, so Hitman Pro and Zamana have finished scanning, and the machine is pretty badly infected. We have a lot of suspicious browser settings. We have it detected the wallpaper that was changed by Locky. We have some Trojans running around, DLL files, etc. Potentially unwanted program. So Malwarebuster said that it removed five infections, detected five infections, and then got rid of them. A lot of these are actually, you know, kind of the same infection. A lot of it's from that script. But I'll give it the benefit of the doubt and say that it got rid of five malware infections. However, it didn't do well at all in terms of preventing a, you know, we have a ransomware on here. We have some Trojans. It's still, the machine is badly infected. Even though it got rid of five malware infections, the machine is still badly infected. And even for a second opinion scanner, I consider that to be a fail. So that's just not good at all. So anyways, I'm going to restore this machine back to a clean state, and then I'm going to grab a pack of malware and stick it on the desktop, and then we'll see what its overall detection rate is. So I'll be back. Okay, so I have disabled Malwarebuster's real-time protection, and I have dragged the malware file onto the desktop. We have 495 items this time, so I'm going to do a right-click scan with Malwarebuster, see how many it detects, and I'll be back with the results. Okay, so Malwarebuster finished scanning, and out of the 495 items we had, it left over 194, so let's do the detection ratio here. So 495 minus 194, 301 out of 495, 60.8%, which is not good at all. So even for a second opinion scanner, that's terrible. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to re-enable the real-time protection. And just as a heads up to everybody, the scan time and the removal time, it takes a long time. So I'm going to run some of these, but knowing how it handled the first part of the test, I'm guessing there's not going to be a whole lot of action here. So anyways, let's go ahead and start executing some of these. Here's our first one. That one appears to have executed successfully. Yep, and it's loaded, looks like a payload into memory. So let's go with the next one. Just going to go down the list here and just pick these at random. There's one. There's one. Oh boy, I think we might be having a problem here. Yeah, that's not good. We're getting a bunch of errors here, and now I can't even run these executable files anymore because it doesn't even know what the file type is. So let me see if Zamana will run. Nope, Zamana won't even run anymore. So what about Task Manager? Task Manager is disabled now. Yeah, so I can't even continue this test anymore. I'm not sure if we have a patching virus on here or something else. Let me try to delete Hitman Pro at least and see if I can bring it back on. I can't even open Windows Explorer. Wow. This machine is totally disabled now. And so is Malwarebuster. Nothing works on this machine anymore. In terms of the shortcuts, at least. So uh, I'm not sure that I can even go anywhere. Well, there we go. Maybe I can bring, okay, so I brought Hitman Pro back on the machine. I paused the video there so I could kind of figure out how to make this work. So I'm going to run this and see what we got on here. And then I'll be back with the results. Okay, so overall, Hitman Pro has found a lot of stuff. Looks like we have some sort of a patching virus or patching malware on here. A lot of these infections are the same thing. And it looks like it's infected the system processes as well. Probably why I can't use Task Manager and that sort of stuff. We have all of these options that have been disabled. I can't use Registry Editor. Folder Options has been removed. Command Prompt has been disabled. Bunch of tracking cookies, no one cares about that. We have some malware running around. And when I try to use Zamana, it just crashes, or is killed by a malware process. So this machine is disabled for the most part. So Malware Buster is a complete fail. It does not work. It is not worth the money they're asking for. And don't use it. It doesn't protect your computer. It wouldn't even be good to back up your antivirus. I mean, their detection rate is not that great. It has zero abilities to detect unknown malware. Some of those malware infections were probably, you know, no well-known malware, and it's not detecting them. So it doesn't have good ransomware protection, as you saw. It doesn't have good malware protection. It detected 60%, which is just not good. I don't know. It's not a serious contender in the second opinion scanner category. It's not a serious contender in the malware protection industry at all, at least right now. It needs a lot of work. So hope you guys enjoyed this review. Malware Buster is a fail. Don't use it. Don't buy it. It's not worth it. Thanks for watching. I'll talk to you guys later.